For nearly 2.5 years, the two Michaels have remained out of reach. Canadian Spavor and Kovrig, accused by Beijing of spying. Their trials held behind closed doors. Their ordeal difficult to even imagine. But not for Julia and Kevin Garratt.
Our situation is very similar to the Michaels.
The Canadian couple lived in China for 3 decades before their arrest in 2014, accused of spying following the arrest of a Chinese suspect in Canada at the request of the United States. The Garratts were held in separate cells, interrogated for 6 hours every day.
They threatened execution many times.
They each kept diaries.
In John 15.
Kevin wrote Bible verses about hope, while Julia scribbled pictures of anything she was grateful for.
Like, I heard a bird outside. I heard like some chirping of a bird, so I drew like a few birds. Because the other alternative is you get lost in bitterness, anger, rage, and I knew that wasn't a good choice.
But as the months dragged on, their notes grew darker.
Like, you get into this more deep, deep despair.
After 7 months, Julia was released, but not Kevin. Like the Michaels, his trial was also closed to the public, which he believes is actually a positive.
If it was a public trial, meaning there were spectators, it will not go away. They're going to make an example of you.
Kevin was later convicted of spying, but unbeknownst to him, political relations were warming. The Chinese suspect in Canada suddenly pleaded guilty, and Prime Minister Trudeau visited China amid talk of a possible trade deal. 2 weeks later, Kevin was released, reunited with his family. The Garratts say the government's quiet backdoor diplomacy helped to secure their release.
So their approach was extremely diplomatic, and so it wasn't in the media.
They're doing it differently with the two Michaels. Some quiet action, but more in the news and in their face.
But even when it seems insurmountable, their story is a reminder of how quickly the winds can change.
I think I would say you hold on. It will not last forever.
Jeff Semple, Global News, Toronto.
You can listen to China Rising on Apple Podcasts, Spotify, Amazon Music, or wherever you get your favorite podcasts.